I will say two things. One, that the result that Anel has shown, the Wiemann-Quine theory experiment, even surprised the Eddie. Did this experiment, just to say that he's a world leader experimentalist in collisions, but he also know about theory, did the theory with me about non-remission, so he knows what the resonances are. And the surprise is to see such a beautiful agreement, because the experiment is never so clean as one may think. So actually, I think the big surprise is not the theory agree with the experiment, that the experiment is so clean. This is from my point. The agreement can be even better because you can use a convolution to take into consideration the spreading of the velocities in the because the temperature is not zero Kelvin. And when you use such convolution, and I didn't show it, you get even better effect. This is a second order effect. The nice thing that about this formula that Anel has shown is that it can be used not only for one-dimensional problems, actually, because we actually effectively reduce the problem to a set of uncoupled one-dimensional problems. But it can be used for other situations. For example, when this adiabatic approximation breaks down, it can happen. Or when you want to include also the vibration of the diatomic into consideration, then even in the cold collision experiment, we'll have two-dimensional surface in the end of the story. Even when you use the adiabatic approximation, the two coordinates will be the distance of the helium for the center of mass of hydrogen, and also the vibration of hydrogen. So this formula is, we have two approaches to. One, how we got it. We got it based on the non-remission scattering theory. This is chapter 8 or 7 in the book, I don't remember. Nine is about the exception points. So I think it's 8. The proof is, I'm not sure how rigorous it is, because there are assumptions, namely rigorous. We make, as usual, you know, we make a series of assumptions. And then we wanted, because of any comments, we wanted to see more clearly in a simple model what's going on. In particular, because there are experimental results that were obtained in Ebner Yevich's group in Weizmann, where the decay rates are very much larger than in this case. And then simple calculations had problems because people in optics know it, that as the index of reflection, for example, the imaginary part becomes large enough, it's not absorbed but less reflection. So on the back of the envelope, you may think that when the decay rates in the complex potential is very large, suddenly very large, the molecules that collide will not have the reaction, because they will reflect it backward and it will be elastic scattering. They will not really have an inelastic scattering so much. But I can explain more about this, but this was a hand-waving intuition that does. There is some interesting to study. And this is the second project we thought about, very simple model. Nobody can argue that it can be simpler than our. So, now, what do you want? Do you want to take a break or you want to continue? Ofer, you are the leader of this group. What do you
say? I'm not sure.
He's a good leader. He's looking back of his shoulder to see what the other says also. Okay, so.
Good. So, this is Nimrod Gap's motivation. We
you can repeat on it because you explain usually better than me. So. So far it was.
Okay, the name of the project now is autoionization reaction probability, what we calculate for as an experiment from CPS, but for a simple model Hamiltonian. And this model can fit to any mechanism because autoionization reaction, well, there is one particle that is excited state and it's interact or collide with another particle named B and they decay to A plus B plus B cation B. This autoionization reaction takes place in different mechanism. And as we said, the potential of A excited B is complex, and in this project we want we have two aims. One, to check our formula. We take a model that we can solve analytically, and we can know the probability of the reaction, and we can compare our formula to the probability of the model for the model. And in addition, we want to check what Nimrod talked about it, about the reflection. When we increase the gamma of R, when it's very large at the interaction region, on one end, it looks like if it's zero elsewhere and only the interaction region is large, the reactants will avoid getting into the interaction region. And if they are not there, the reaction cannot occur. But it's weird because on the other end, gamma of R gives the decay rate. And if it's large, we can expect that the probability will be large. So we take this model that V is the real part of V is zero anywhere, and the imaginary part of V is zero outside the interaction region when R is larger or equal to A, and inside the interaction region is a constant minus I gamma zero divided by two. So the reaction can take place only when the reactant came to the interaction region. So the corresponding Schrödinger equation for that, like that, where for the when in the interaction region, it's like a well, but imaginary well, but outside the interaction region, it's like free particle. And this is a corresponding solution. AE assign this thing for at the interaction region where AE is a coefficient that depends on E. For each psi, we have a different AE. And outside the interaction region, it's like a free particle where we have the outgoing waves where there are the amplitude is B, and the incoming wave where the amplitude is C, and we flux normalize it by this factor to make sure that the number of particles that comes and go is not depend on their velocity. Okay, for this model, we can know the probability. Because if a particle comes from the asymptote to the interaction region, the probability of it to react is if it will stay in the interaction region. If it will escape, it will not react. So we can say that the probability of the reaction is the probability of the incoming particle to stay in the interaction region. Okay, so what's the probability to stay in the interaction region is one minus the probability of it to escape. That this is the amplitude of the incoming outgoing waves, divided is the ratio between the outgoing waves and the incoming waves. In our calculation, we normalize the amplitude of the incoming waves to be one for all the energies. So now for the results. We found AE and B by the demand that psi E of R is smooth with smooth derivative at A. And then we can calculate the reaction probability by our two formulas. the formula of the probability of the particle to stay at the interaction region and the expectation value of the decay rate. And we found that analytically they are the same. We got the same expression analytically. So we can say that our formula is correct. And we looked at the reaction probability for some values of gamma zero, the constant at the potential. We can see from this graph that for relatively high energy, the probability is higher when gamma zero is higher. The purple one correspond to gamma zero that equal to half. The blue one correspond to gamma zero that equal to 0.05. And the green one is correspond to 0.005. And as you can see, the purple is higher than the blue, and both of them are higher than the green. But for relatively low energies, the opposite happens. The green one is higher than the blue, and the blue is higher than the purple. But it's all relative. the energy that determine where for the lower gamma will give the lower probability and opposite is different for each gamma couples. Okay, for the green and the blue is here, and for the green and the purple is in higher energy. So maybe it's better to look at the reaction probability in specific energy, and to see how the probability in this energy changes according to gamma, when gamma increases. So here you can see that for enough small gamma, the reaction probability increases when gamma increases, and the increase is very sharp. And then for higher gamma, the reaction probability decreases when gamma increases, but it's less sharp than the increase. And also we can see that the decretion are less significant when the energy is higher. The decretion is associated with the reflection, that we increase the gamma and there is more reflection. Okay? So we saw that the reflection is higher. Yes, is higher when the energies are lower. Maybe it makes sense if the particle has higher energy, he has more energy to penetrate the interaction region. Also, there is a reflection. Okay, so this is from the calculation of the reaction probability. And now we want to look about the resonances. We found the resonances. This is the nuclear resonances. By look for the complex energies that obtain that BE, the amplitude of the outgoing waves, is equal to zero. It's like applying incoming boundary condition. And it means that this resonance that obeyed incoming boundary condition are capture resonances and not decay as we used to have. Okay. in addition, we got, so if it's capture resonances, we expect to have a positive imaginary part. Okay? So this is positive. But then we got that the gamma res, the gamma of the resonance, the decay capture rate, because this is not decay rate, this is not decay resonance, this is the capture resonance, so now it's capture decay, is not from zero to infinity, but from minus gamma zero, is the decay rate of the ionization, until infinity.
In the previous slide, this gamma should be gamma zero?
Yes. I got low.
Just remember to correct them in the other plots.
Yes, I need to make him maximum. Okay, so from this we can conclude that gamma is not the gamma the capture rate, but it's composed from two components, the capture rate and the ionization rate. Okay. So now, for example, the resonances for gamma zero is equal to 0.005. We can see that we have two resonances. I'm not sure if you can see this. Two resonances that has negative imaginary part, where one of them, this, has very close to zero gamma, and another resonances with positive gamma. And if we compare it to the probability reaction that we calculate, we can see that these peaks are associated to the resonances. The energy of the peaks are the energy of the resonances. And we found that the resonances that correspond to the maximal probability is the resonance that has the most close to zero gamma. In addition, what we saw that when the gamma capture became larger, you can see that the gamma of the resonance increases when the energy of the resonance increases. So we saw that when the gamma capture become larger, the probability of the reaction decrease. Okay? This is for gamma raise equal to zero, and then the probability decrease. And it was surprising because we thought that the problem is only reflection, but if the particle will capture in its interaction region, so the reaction should be, the probability of the reaction should be larger. But we saw that when the capturing is so strong, it avoid also the reactant to react. This is for gamma zero, larger gamma zero, 0.05. And also we can see here that we have that the maximal probability corresponds to the resonance that has most close to zero gamma. And for larger gamma, the reaction decrease, and also for smaller gamma. Also, we can see that now we have more resonances that has negative imaginary part, negative gamma. Okay, all this. And before we have only two. So this this explains the reflection by the resonances for you, that when gamma is larger, there is more resonances that has negative gamma, and then the captures are not enough strong to get them, the reactant will come to the interaction region. So this is the reason that we can see that here the probability is lower in low energies. So maybe it will summarize more. This is the interim conclusion. So we saw that the resonances with gamma rays smaller than zero are reflection resonances. In these resonances, the gamma of ionization are larger than gamma capture. So it avoids them because gamma is too large according to their capture rate. It avoids them to get into the interaction region. And then reflection are shown. And when gamma zero is larger, there are more reflection resonances, and therefore there are more reflection in the probability. And we also saw, and I want to prove you that by some example, that the maximal probability obtained when gamma rays is closer, is closest to zero. And I will show you some example that my interpretation is not that because this is the resonance, the more narrow resonance, most narrow resonance, but it's because the ratio between the rate of the capturing and the rate of the ionization. Okay, that is, if it's one, the reaction will be the maximal. But if one of them are more, it will decrease the reaction. Yes, when gamma capture is larger than the gamma ionization, the reaction probability is smaller. As we saw that for these resonances, the capture rate is larger, and therefore the reaction is smaller than when it's small, when the capture rate is like the ionization rate. Maybe here it's more significant, no? Okay, so I want to prove you that this ratio is what is matter and not the fact that gamma rays is close to zero. So why for small gamma zero, the maximal probability is smaller than one? For example, for this gamma zero, 5 × 10⁻⁴, the maximal probability is only 0.8, and not one, or almost one, as we saw here and here. If we look at the resonances, we see that the most close to zero gamma res is for the resonances with this energy, and gamma res is 1.3 E minus 3. This is relatively close to zero. For example, for gamma zero that equal to 0.01, the maximal probability is almost one, or exact one, and the resonances that associate with this maximum as gamma res that equal to 1.6 E minus 3. So it's larger than gamma res of the smaller gamma zero. So we would accept that also for these resonances we will have a maximal reaction probability that is one. But if we look, no. If we look at the ratio, we can see that for when gamma zero is larger, the ratio is more close to one than when gamma zero is smaller. So I think this proves that what is matter is the ratio between the rate of the two mechanisms. And also, no. This can explain why for higher gamma zero, it's a potential, higher ionization rate, the range of the energies that obtained the maximal probability is larger. Because when the gamma of the capture they increase with the energy, but it's still according to the gamma ionization, it's not increased a lot. Okay, so, and this is only two slides because I didn't get it into it a lot. We thought how to improve our model by adding a well and to see what how it influences and what the meaning of being close to the threshold energy. So it's like adding V0, it's like taking in the previous formulas imaginary gamma, complex gamma. So all the formulas are the same. And we look at the reaction probability for gamma 0 that equal to 0.05. And we see that there are more oscillations when we take a well, once we take a well of alf and once I didn't take a well. This is a reaction probability you saw before. And after taking a well, we get more oscillations. And in some energies, the reaction probability decrease. And now we looked at the resonances. Yes. And as you can see, the resonance is now more less dense. Here is the resonance with the well, and there is without the well. So here, and the scale is the same. So here you can see that it's more dense. And also because the resonances are less dense, there are less reflection resonances. So also there are less reflection resonances. I still didn't get to, I didn't interrupt this result too much. And it's because the capture rate is larger. It means that the capture rate is larger when we have a well. It's more absorbed the incoming particle. And finished. So the conclusion is that our formula, that the probability is the expectation value of psi, and the formula that we used for this model are equivalent. And in autoionization reactions, there are two mechanisms that compete with each other, the capturing of the incoming particle at the interaction region, and the ionization to get the product. Okay, so these two mechanisms that compete, and the maximal reaction probability obtained when the rate of the two mechanisms are equal, and when the ionization rate is larger, then the capture rate, when the autoionization rate is larger than the capture rate, reflection from the interaction are more significant. And therefore, when the ionization rate is larger, there are more reflections because there are more cases that the ionization rate is larger than the capture rate. And when the capture rate is larger, when the energy is larger, because we saw that the energy of when we increase the energy of the resonance, we get a larger gamma of the resonances. And this explains us why the reflections are shown in low temperatures. And thank you.
Ratio of gamma capture to gamma ionization is really what matters.
Yes.
So I would suggest that maybe you should, if you can, plot just a graph showing the probability of your reaction as a function of this ratio, even for a given resonance, instead of just showing like specific points where you show it's bigger, it's smaller. You could just plot the graph and see.
For a given, you mean by a given resonance, by a given potential?
Yes. I mean, you can scan different potentials, whatever you need to do to vary this parameter.
I'll try. Do you not succeed?
Because, I mean, even to getting different rates, you need different gamma zeros, right?
Yes.
So you can scan with whatever just to see if indeed.
I want to find a formula to calculate the reaction rate, correction probability from the resonances. So I think this ratio will play a role there in this formula. And then maybe it will explain.
Question about this point as well. Would the possible explanation be that for every capture resonance, there's also an associated decay resonance? And when you increase the capture rate, you also increase the decay rate. So that makes sense why the ratio is what's important, because you don't want to increase the decay as well once you increase the capture rate.
I'm not sure I understand. Again?
It's so only one of the capture resonances has an associated decay resonance on the other side of
yes.
the real axis as well. So once you increase the capture rate, you in turn increase the decay rate as well.
But if I impose B to equal to zero, it cannot be decay.
Yeah, you'll
of the resonance.
The capture resonance.
Yes.
But you could do the reverse process and set C to zero and look for the values of B, and then you'll find all of the decay resonances that should be the same.
Ah. I understand.
So once you perform the collision, then you're gonna have the decay resonances coming into play as well. So
mm-hmm.
if you decay faster than you can ionize, then obviously you're gonna get thrown out. Or maybe that's just another way of looking at the reflection.
I'm not sure this is in the same energy, because I looked for, but I will check.
Okay. But for one-dimensional systems, they should be just complex.
Yes, it's not a problem. We have analytical formulas for all. It's only to substitute grid.
Is it clear what are the potential well when we, because you didn't make the plot.
Ah, yes.
What yeah. potential well?
It's like, what is it? Yes, it's like.
So, what she did, she took gamma zero to be complex. So, this is the way. So, the imaginary part of gamma zero is the way.
Maybe you reflect around gamma zero now.
It's like this, yes. It's in the simple model, so this is, you call it XOR, how do R, okay? And this is the real of the potential, so it was this everywhere. And the imaginary part was this, when this was minus gamma zero divided by two, no?
Yes.
This what you did. So let's put it like this. This is zero, and here it was this. Now, when she take, this is nowhere. When she did really well, then here it was like this. And this was minus, how you call it?
Visual.
Minus V0,
yes.
V0
is negative.
And here was the same as here. So this is what she did. Now, during your talk, I thought about illustration of what you have done. You will help me to say if what I said is nonsense or it's really realistic. So maybe I'll move to here. It doesn't.
No.
Yes. Okay. So I want to make a cartoon, and with your help to tell me if this cartoon makes sense or it's just what I dreamed during your talk. I thought about a sink, and there is an opening here, and this is our gamma zero, because this gave us the rate of, if you call it, of ionization. So this is going to the, and here, this is the gamma alpha capture, because this say the rate that the particles are get into the interaction region. So this is what I have. And also notice that if gamma alpha, the capture, is smaller than zero, it implies that this is gamma decay. Gamma captured the imaginary part of the complex eigenvalues is real, decay is negative. So when this happened to be negatives, as you have shown, it implies that this one actually are not captured, but actually decay. This is the definition of decay, and because when you solve it, you get in some, in the low energies, you get resonances with gamma alpha smaller than zero, correct?
Yes.
So they are, by definition, they are captures, and actually you said it, because you sum of, over all the possibilities of alpha, and this is why you said that actually when there are, you have many of these, this actually make the probability for the reaction to be smaller. This is what you said. And the way, this is why I thought about this. So if I have only one, then it's clear. If gamma alpha, the capture, is smaller than gamma zero, then every drop that is coming here go to the reaction. But if gamma alpha capture is much larger than gamma zero, maybe to do it only like this, it implies that you have a flood of water, of drops like this, and they are accumulated here, and only part of them will go down. So if you do it very, very fast, this decay rate, the fact that there is a small hole here, a hole in the sink, will not help to evacuate all this, this everyone that has unfortunately a flood in when the in the machine the washing machine breaks down and all the water get out. The fact that you have a hole someplace in the bathroom doesn't help you to avoid the flood. So it's accumulated. So this is what I have in my imagination. Now, the fact that in your calculation you have seen that the fact that this is much smaller than this is not enough, that actually you need it to be equal to this gamma. So my intuition, I don't know if it's correct or not, it's that if it's that actually you don't have only one tap like this. You sum over all them. So you have alpha 1 and 2, blah, blah, blah. So you have actually many, many, at any given energy that you're speaking, you have many, many resonances, captures. So all of them are open. And some of them are captured, some of them are decay. So this makes this situation more complicated. But this is my cartoon. If this cartoon helps, or on the opposite, don't afraid to tell me, or be shy to tell me that it's only confusing. מה אתם אומרים? Pardon?
Give them intuition about this.
Well, this is what I tried, but
just need to differentiate between the rate of incoming particles, which is gamma alpha minus gamma zero.
Yes, this is what you did.
The resulting rate, which is a sort of steady state that mm-hmm. takes into account both the hole and the faucet.
Mm-hmm.
So we found that gamma alpha are smaller than zero, but they're not decay resonances because they're still incoming waves.
Gamma
alpha minus gamma zero is always positive. That's always the faucet dripping down.
Yes, that's correct. Yes, correct.
Just the result is that we have a total rate of particles going down.
Mm. Yes. Anyhow, this is I think the most important for me was to see that this formula that we're using, you can explain it in a simple model in a very clear and cut way.
Was it verified for the real one as well?
What?
The 1 minus BE over CE squared, was that equal to your formula for the complex polygon, not just imaginary?
Yes, because it's only to take gamma zero as complex.
This is very good. This is very good things to remember to address, because most of the talk was about this situation that the real part is zero and the imaginary part has such a step function, The well implies that we have a well, and as I mentioned at the beginning, it implies that the gamma zero become to be complex. So all the equations that she solved to get incoming waves and outgoing waves and capture resonances and decay resonances, all of them, all these expressions remain the same. It's only in the code to take gamma zero to be complex. So it's important to actually to show that indeed, well, this by definition implies that when she see that the expectation value of gamma, in our case gamma zero, is exactly like the ratio between the outgoing waves and incoming waves. So this holds for any value of gamma. So this is clear cut. Then the question of the oscillations, it's nice to see also that it works also to edit such a graph.
About the phase of both of your expressions. I assume that you took just the absolute value of 1 minus V over CE, or?
I took the absolute value of the ratio between the amplitudes.
Mm-hmm. This is the phase, this is the S matrix, actually. The
it's
ratio between the incoming and outgoing.
It's the S matrix squared.
Yes.
And the same for the matrix element of psi, gamma psi? Just to be absolute value squared?
Yes, I used here the scalar product.
You still get a copy?
Absolute number.
Oh, because the gamma just come out.
Well, remember that she showed this expression is identical.
This expression is real by definition?
Yes.
It's by definition because. She compare it to the ratio of the amplitudes, which is the but absolute value square. So this is what she did. Okay, if not, thank you. And